my great-grandma's funeral. My great-grandma's great-grandma was a great woman of faith, and it was so great to see a great big family of her children, grandchildren, and even great-grandchildren who are Christians. I have grown up in a Christian family, which is a blessing. They have told me through the tough times and helped me to come to Christ. But I made the decision myself to follow the true King, Jesus. Life isn't easy, and neither is being a Christian, but Jesus told us that we have to take a narrow path. I've made and lost many friends, and at times I questioned if God was real, but I eventually found an even greater comforter than friends and family, God. I came to realize that I may be put through trials, but God will always love me no matter what. As it is Easter, we remember the crucifixion and resurrection of Jesus. We remember God's great love and grace. A famous verse, and one of my favorite verses, tells us about his love, John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, so that whoever believes in him will not perish but have eternal life. God showed us amazing love. He even sacrificed his only Son so that we could live. This love has comforted and encouraged me through the years. I am a Christian. I love God. And I believe that Jesus is the true King, the Messiah, and the Son of God. Today, I am being obedient to him by getting baptized. Getting baptized is about showing my faith, showing that I know that Jesus is my Savior.
And leader of your life. Well, on profession of that faith, I baptize you in the names of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, before I guess we even pray for Rachel, we think of what's represented here and we say, thank you, Jesus. We know we could never be good enough for you, God, but Jesus, you died in our place. You rose again in victory. And so we thank you as we stand around the waters of baptism. We thank you for Jesus, for your death and resurrection. But today, Lord, we also want to rejoice and give thanks for Rachel. We give you thanks, as she has said, that certainly I rejoice in the Christian heritage of my family, as she's rejoiced today. We thank you for the faithfulness of those people. And Father, we rejoice that she made her own decision to follow Jesus. No one's saved by their family. Everyone has to make their own choice about who Jesus is and what he's done. And Rachel's made that choice, that Jesus is her forgiver, Jesus is her leader. And we rejoice in this day and that choice she's made.